Good afternoon, viewers. Welcome back to the channel. I am Birdman Johnson. We're playing Dwarf Fortress. We're here in Drink Fountain. Got a few things to show you before we get started. First of all, here is our completed execution chamber. If you haven't figured it out by now, I'm pretty sure you can guess what's supposed to happen here, and we'll be talking more about this in a minute. We're storing ballista bolts up here. We put a roof on it. It's looking pretty nice. Also, you might have noticed that we have finished the fortifications. Yes, we have walls. There are arrow slits in them. They're not entirely regular. So I've just had to make the rational choice to accept that. If we go up here, we have some stained glass in the temple. We're going to put in some more on that western wall. Let's see, we're also going to build some scaffolding here so that we can put some in over the main tavern. I say main tavern, but so far they are preferring the one with the minecarts. That's fine. Okay, so that's going to happen. We're also putting in some employee housing up here. Let's move on with that. You can see there, a little bit to the left, we've also installed some beehives. Why? There we go. Hotkey was not working. Do we have enough beds? I think we have enough beds. We have some highly decorated furniture now. These are just little rooms, but amazingly, the dwarves are okay with this, even if they have to share with a spouse and a child. It's interesting. But I suppose we can adapt to much worse spaces than this. Hope everyone had a good holiday. The next one's coming up in a little less than a month. I don't know yet what we're doing for that. I mean, you Dwarf Fortress viewers will continue to get Dwarf Fortress content. That is my gift to you every week. We only need two more of these right now. Okay, that's happening. So then, is anybody injured up here? Not presently, there's nobody in the hospital, so good. Oops, too far. I think this winter we're gonna get started digging basements for the freestanding units. I think that would be a nice gift to the dwarves from me. And we can tear down this staircase any old time. Now then, the problem with the execution chamber is that we have no one to put in it. As you can see, we have put cage traps outside the gates. This is a very familiar design for those of you who have been watching my channel for any length of time. We're going to continue to scatter these around the map once I get a really solid idea of where the invaders come in. But the thing is, well, viewers, let me ask you, what's the best way to get victims caught in our cage traps? A siege. And it's been a little while since we've gotten a siege, so what's the best way to get a siege? We're gonna provoke them. Yes, that's right. We have another baby, bringing us to 62 out of 50 dwarves. Did we lose somebody? Unclear. Alright, anyway. So what we're going to do here, we're just going to have a look. We need a crossbow squad is what we need. What is the uniform on these? Okay, well, it's going to be metal armor then. okay, so we need to create a new squad. These guys are going to get archer because it doesn't really matter. And then, do we have anybody with existing bow skills who's not already in a squad? Well, yeah, how about the hunters? Oh, wow. Okay. How about anybody already in a squad? Anybody at all? There we go. We got one. We're a fairly small fort. We don't have a lot of fighters in the first place. Can I get three more? No, I cannot. So that is our entire Marx Dwarf squad. Amazingly, we only need to replace one. Okay, it's going to be Aban the Performer, newcomer to the fort. Okay. Then we need to make sure we have some crossbows. And at some point here, we'll need to start a metalworking industry so that we can make them some decent arrows. I'm trying to get all this fish processed. It is... Oh, we're actually fine. Okay, then you can kill those. Right, because this is all rotten, isn't it? No? No, it's not. I don't understand, then. Please continue. Boy. So much fish. And I keep making containers. Be really cool if they could... Like, is the problem that they're rock pots and not wooden barrels? I can keep making containers, you just have to use them. Anyway, our plan is to keep doing what we did last time. We're going to pick nice, safe, small targets, like Kindled Poison here. We're going to raid them. We'll send out one squad at a time here. And through this, we will gain both militia training and hopefully some totally warranted aggression that we can use. Hang on. What are you carrying? A door. You're taking a door with you on maneuvers. Sure. Okay. Anyway, we're going to try to provoke the goblins into attacking us. And then when they do that, we will hopefully catch them in our cage traps. I'm also thinking about putting in an apron. Oh, hey, a human caravan's here. Anyway, gonna put in an apron around the outside of the wall here to stop trees from growing up around it, but that's gonna wait a little bit, because that'll take some time. Anyway, let me... Where are they coming in? Oh, right there. All right, let me pause real quick, and then we'll come back when we're all ready to finish up with the merchants. So hey, the dwarves have found a gap in the wall. Look at that, there's a little diagonal gap there, so we are going to tear that down, and that's going to become a wall. Oopsie doodle. That could have been a disaster. Where are we on this? A lot of garbage, a lot of food and drink, many, many, many crafts. Okay, we're not nearly there yet. All right, stand by again. I just... wanted to show you this horrible mistake I almost made. Alright, and here we are on the trade screen. We can zoom back in now. You know, it's the usual assortment of things. We're taking a lot of food and some drink items. They actually brought us some bolts, which is nice. So we're taking all of their non-silver crossbow bolts. We are buying all of their textiles to try to fix our clothing issue. Otherwise, it's pretty typical stuff. They brought us a small number of gems that we're going to take. Over here currently, we're making them take all these white items that we cannot give as gifts. So those are going to be our trade goods. They're very happy with that. And then we are simply going to force them to take... Just making absolutely sure I'm not trading any artifacts. We're just going to take a quick scroll down here. We're going to force them to take all of our stuff. Oh, not that. I missed one. That is... Everything we can give them as a gift, we're forcing them to take. I'm getting distracted here. All right, I think we're good. Including a lot of garbage. Boop, boop. There we go. Trader done. All right, Izum is still a sad girl. Sad girl hours have begun in the tavern. I noticed some of our instruments are missing. I may have accidentally traded those. But that's fine, we weren't using them anyway. Okay. Also, the militia came back, so let's have a look at the mission report. Okay, they went in and stole some stuff. Was it anything worth taking? Not really, is the answer. Not particularly. The best thing we got is maybe that iron mail shirt, because we can melt it down. I don't know. However, with that done, we are going to hit the same settlement again with the next squad down the list. This is all the training they shall receive. Also, this corpse is still here. It does not go away when the water freezes. So we will have to retrieve that. Which will actually not be all that hard. Okay. Still working on that. What is that? Wild boar blood. Okay, the pigs came up here. There's some wine there. Here's a weird one for you. There's turnip wine down here in this murky pool. Not sure how that happened. Not gonna question it. We're just gonna let that do. How much stuff do we have in this smash pile? Oh, we have some mussel shells that we could be using. Oh no. Decorate with shell, please. And we have, I don't know, some of this somewhere. I think maybe we have, not that. Maybe we have some stuff to make totems with, I don't know. I don't care. Get rid of it all. All right. Let's do this. Okay. So then, looking at our cloth stockpile, we have wool that we can use. Which is actually yarn. So we're gonna make some yarn robes and some yarn tunics, yarn dresses, I think, yarn togas, yarn cloaks, perhaps? Yes, cloaks. Okay. We'll make some cloth trousers. We'll make some cloth caps, cloth hoods. We'll make some leather hoods. Make some leather shoes. We'll make some yarn and cloth socks. That'll get us started. There's a Thrun soldier on the map. Not in love with that, but the militia is running it off. Where'd you come from? Where'd you go? Oh, there you are. Just lost track of it for a second there. Huh? Let's see, okay. L. Where are you? There. And we're gonna follow you. Where'd you come from? What are you doing here? Should I be worried? Are more of them about to enter the map? Probably should assign some war dogs to the militia. There we go, we are running it down. Are we doing damage? Yeah, we are. Arish beached stockades, the recruit, is slowly getting the job done. There we go, okay. Okay, but that appears to be the only one, so we just won't worry about that for now. We'll just pretend that didn't happen. Mm-hmm. Okay, these are all done. So we can designate these as bedrooms now. We're missing a door. Right, that was the door that went out on maneuvers. Inexplicably. These are smaller than the other bedrooms. It's fine. It doesn't matter. Good. Plant and fruit booze. We're making some lavish meals. We're getting the fish processed. Everything is happening. How wonderful. Okay, so let's get started on some more rock blocks for that apron I want to lay down. I'm going to start here. This might look kind of unattractive when we're done, but oh, nope, never mind. We ain't doing nothing there yet. Why has this not been torn down? Is there too much else to do? New arrivals. Hey, they came back. Okay, so this place is just down the road, is the point. We stole a single iron bow. We're gonna go back. We're gonna send our Mark's Dwarf squad, which I did fill out with just some random performers. Actually, I probably shouldn't do that, because I'm gonna have to reassign the performers every time they come back, aren't I? Well, it's fine. If I go through here right now. No, looks like we're gonna be okay. All right, we'll see what happens. Okay, the humans are here, which means it's summer and I just missed the seasonal autosave. I would really love to have some captives to try this out on. I know that's messed up, I don't care. I don't just want to use random animals, I want to have actual captives. Good, we've got some beehives now. Oh yeah, I've decided that part of this is going to be livestock space. Not that. There we go, I do have nest boxes. That's no good. These actually don't have to be spaced at all. That's just me being silly. There we go. We'll put some birds in there. We'll start collecting some eggs. In fact, we'll put the birds in there now. Alright, what do we got in the way of egg layers? We got a peahen. We'll put you up there with the peacock. Duck. Dogs do not lay eggs as far as I'm aware at this time. The raven has to wait. Nope, that's all we got. Okay. Because our egg layers were killed during early attacks. So that's, you know, that's less than ideal. But we will get more. Could somebody please do that? I know you can get up there. I know you can get up there. No, we're having too much fun playing with the minecarts. Oh, hey. Okay. Yeah, that'll work. You know, whenever someone feels like getting around to it, that's the real problem. Still got some folks rolling out. The merchants are leaving soon, which is no longer a problem. We no longer have a use for them. At 140 subscribers as of last night, I think at 150 we'll be due for another Dwarf Fortress subscriber appreciation special. That's what I think. Haven't done one of those for a while. And I appreciate my Dwarf Fortress viewers. You keep the channel running. You give me the overwhelming majority of my views, and I am appreciative of that. There's nothing in this cage, don't tease me. Boy, this is really a lush, verdant area. If we chose well. Okay, great. Squad's back. Looks like they didn't find anything. Oh. Well, we did kill somebody. So that's nice. Song Monstrous Zealots. Who was that? That was... these guys, the crossbow dwarves. So since they're back, that means it's time to cycle in the next group. Oh, okay. Well, that's unfortunate. Ezum has finally lost it. What are Ezum's skills? We can't see that in information anymore. Oh, but she has a crossbow. That's not helpful. Who's engaging right now? This is Aban the Recruit. Slightly wounded. Shot in the guts. Gut shot. Bad way to die. Slow death, usually. Okay, Ezum the Leatherworker. Longtime resident of the fort. Chronically depressed. Now dead. Alas. Fortunately. We'll... there we go. Did we want to do that? Actually, do we already have... we do have another burial receptacle. We're just going to keep lining them up along this wall. That's what we're going to do. Now you are Aban. And you have Mamotingas? Are you Mamotingas? You are Mamotingas. You already have a burial place. With nothing in it. So you will be very excited to get out of that hole later, I guess. Out of that murky pool. Okay, so we have an injured dwarf going to the hospital. That's good. We have an injured dwarf going to the hospital, right? Hmm. Yes, okay, good. Aban the Recruit is going to rest, but where? Where is our dear boy going to rest? Just the gut shot. Ooh, the spleen. Painful. Okay, we are indeed going to the hospital. That's what I was hoping for. Then we just need a doctor to come check that out. Oh, the merchants have left. Don't especially care, because we already have what we need from them. And the novelty of having humans in the fort has worn off. He's vomiting while he walks. Oh, are you part of the squad that's supposed to be going raiding? You certainly are. Well, now that is going to cause us a problem, my friend. You can go back in your squad when they come back. It's okay, they should be fine with nine. Nobody wants to tear down these structures. That is slightly irritating. I guess there are many other tasks to perform. Look at that. I've never quite gotten the hang of using siege engines in the defense of the fort. This is the main thing I've used them for. Is shooting at helpless captives. It's fine, okay? How are we doing on them rock blocks? Things are happening. And as long as they are happening, they will continue to happen, and that is all I care about. We got a lot of extra furniture lying around here. I was expecting this to be busier. I've had tavern forts before, where we were just constantly inundated with visitors. It's possible that it's just because of how, you know, overwhelmingly hostile our world is. Maybe if I were playing in a world where dwarves were supreme, we'd be getting more visitors, but this is the world in which we live. So, here we go. Wood stockpile's pretty empty. We have enough wood to fill that, I reckon. So it's just a matter of waiting for the dwarves to do things, as we often do. Please stop fishing. Nobody is even fishing right now, so if I go in here... what am I looking for? Not that. Although, as long as we're here... yeah, mangled stuff, that's no good to us. Loose noses, that's no good to us. Yeah, mangled nervous tissue, can't do anything with that. Okay. Not sure what's happening there. That must be stuff that's in the merchant wagons right now. Yeah, those buckets, those are definitely not our buckets. All right. Cheese. We have a lot of cheese. Anyway, none of this. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. Yeah, we got a bunch of rotten stuff here. Needs to go away now. We got some squid. That we traded for from the merchants. Got a lot of logs. What was I? Raw fish. Yep, there we go. That's what I was expecting. Absurd. The good news is, unlike here in Meat Space, there's an infinite supply of fish here, so we can waste as much as we want. This is why we play video games. Okay. Going into work tonight. I work in an entertainment venue in the area, as I've noted before. And we're doing our winter holiday special event all season, which for some reason has me a lot more anxious than usual this year. So I'm not looking forward to it. I'd rather stay here and do this with you, viewers. That's what I want to do. And I encourage you, if you have the opportunity, to do this. The Wings of Crystal have returned. Okay. Angel shark leather robe and an iron pick. Well, so be it. Let's put our guy back in the squad here. We can't. Oh, because they're not actually back yet. Obviously. Okay. Oh, we're at war with them now. That took a minute. Bejeweled Mines, you're up. This is very silly. But it's gonna work. So let me just... Yeah, okay. They belong to this civilization. The Unspeakable Scraps. Not familiar with them. Have we ever interacted with them before? Jobaris? Oh, kobolds. Gotcha. Ooh, should we raid the kobolds? They've got, supposedly, a population of about 10. That should be easy for us, right? That's how we fall into traps, though. We start thinking, oh, this'll be easy. And then it turns out it's not easy. Can we put Aban back in the squad? We sure can. How's Aban doing? Still in the hospital? Out of the hospital. Doing okay. All right. That's what we like to see. Okay, we have broken 10,000 drinks. Oh, it's a beautiful thing. As long as our defenses hold, we can withstand a siege forever. This is going to be a problem, though. So I really, really want someone to get on that. Maybe we stop assigning labors until somebody tears that down. Maybe we pause the raiding momentarily to finish securing our defenses. They are still packing up to leave because we gave them so much stuff. I love it. This is helping nothing. We are just flooding the world with trade goods. Ah, good, the body's been removed. Now this one. We just have to fish out this one, which apparently is not being destroyed by the ice. Okay, that took absolutely forever. They basically did every single other thing there was available to do before getting on that, but I believe we can get started on our apron here. Yes, looks like we can. This is the sort of thing that you would have in front of actual fortifications like this. You want to have a nice clear area. So that the enemy can't just walk up to you. It is going to interact with the road a little bit, which is kind of unfortunate, but there we are. We'll let him get started with that. This isn't the most attractive solution we could have chosen. But I'm happy with it. I know we, like, y'all had anything at all to do with this. Alright, and now with that done, we can resume our cycling. I believe the bejeweled mines are up. Look at all the fish. That's the nice thing about winter is we get a chance to catch up on our fish backlog. Yeah. I think we're secure now. I think. You know what? The merchant caravans don't come in here, so why don't we? Because that's a road. Because there's a road there, so we can't put cage traps outside the doors. That's fine. I'm actually okay with that. Basically, we need to get attacked so that we can see where they're going to prefer to go. And once we know what the pathing looks like, we'll know which areas to trap. We keep taking books out on maneuvers, which is fine, I guess, but, like, you're just going down the road, and you've got a mission. Got plenty of ammo for the ballista battery here. Now we just need something to, shoot at. Oh, we never finished installing this. Behold, the birds. All three of them. Has anybody claimed these yet? I realize these are not the most appealing rooms we have. Ah, there we go. Zugler the planter. And Autumn the woodcutter. Very nice. Oh, did we ever... Good, okay. Again, we're just gonna semi-randomize these. Those of you who watched the Goose Fort have seen this before, where we just kind of try to mix up what gems we're using. It only matters so much. My phone just made a very angry noise. We'll have to see what that's about in a moment. Okay, there we go. I've been getting air stagnation advisories from FEMA all day. Just the Union. Nothing I need to worry about right at this moment. Right now, we're just playing Dwarf Fortress. We're hanging out, playing with the dwarves. And, you know, now that we're cycling through the squads to raid this town, this is feeling an awful lot like a Slaughter Chop or the Hive, except that unlike Slaughter Chop and the Hive, we are not remotely prepared to fight a siege. I am counting on trickery and solid fortifications to win the day for us, as opposed to military might. Which will, you know, probably work well enough in our favor. I'm amazed they still have things for us to take. An unknown civilization? What? What do you mean an unknown civilization? They're goblins. We know exactly what they are. Why are you saying unknown civilization? All right, well, let's hit them again. Go on, get out there. Got a lot of loose ammo lying around. Nope, that's a pick. That's a bunch of stuff. Okay, oh, we can now begin putting in ammo stockpiles. We're gonna start with just a 3 up at the base of each staircase here. I did make sure to get some quivers off the human merchants, even though we could have made those with the leather we got from them, but, you know. We gotta spend all our wealth on something, right? It doesn't do us any good just sitting around here, which I know is very undwarfy of me. But, sorry, I am human at the end of the day. There's no way around that fact. Here they come. And there they go. Oh, good. We got one of the windows in. Twinkling peaceably. Very nice. Very nice. Oh, really? You, Eteb the Carpenter, went immediately to this extremely unsafe area to hang out after coming back. There's no way they don't drop things on the ones below them. See, I was counting on us having more visitors than this. I was counting on us getting, like, monster hunters and such into the fort, and those would be our defense, but that doesn't seem to be happening. So we have to adjust our expectations and our methods to accommodate our reality. Well, those look nice, at least. Okay, and then we have to start painstakingly tearing this down. There you go. Yeah, breaking down the scaffolding is everyone's favorite part. And they're back. Well, there doesn't seem to be anyone there for us to kill now. Less than 10 can be 0, I guess. Bone wraiths? Actually, as long as we're doing this, let's focus on sites that have stuff for us to steal, like this one right here. Send the Wings of Crystal to explore Gaze Demons, where there is at least a book. We can always use more reading material. Is that goblin our only visitor right now? That's not a visitor, that's a citizen. That's Spunstew, the goblin dancer. We have no visitors in the fort right now. That is very unfortunate. I mean, at least the dwarves are enjoying the taverns, I guess. Tavern. It's one big tavern. Ooh, hey. All done. Nope, not quite. Almost, though. Well, that'll look nice. I don't know how that's going to interact with anything, but I will enjoy having it there. The dwarves are able to acclimate to incredibly unpleasant conditions, so let's be honest. The vast majority of what we're doing here is for the benefit of me, the player, and you, the viewers, and not really at all for them, the dwarves. It's autumn now, and with the seasonal change may come a siege. It may have been a mistake to send out a squad this close to the autosave. getting into December now. It's Black Friday as I'm recording this. The only shopping I'm going to do today is buying some Warhammer-type miniatures from some Ukrainian model makers I quite like. Everybody's getting books from me this year. That's what's in the budget. Nope, wrong. There we go. Don't know why you would have been unable to complete that. Yeah, this is gonna look a little gnarly. But, it'll keep trees from growing up against the walls, which should improve security. Yeah, see, those don't quite reach. Oh, hey, there they are. See what I tell ya. Alright, the enemy have come and are laying siege to the fortress. So, bring everybody inside. Hopefully there aren't that many of them. And hopefully they choose to wander into our cage traps. Okay. Okay, let's roll out the militia such as it is, because they kind of drop in right on top of us, which is a problem. There aren't that many of them. So as long as they're not able to gang up on the dwarves, yeah, we're going to suffer some casualties here. That's just something we have to accept, I think. As again, we're not a military outpost. We are a place for dwarves to vomit on the floor in public. Yeah, they stopped coming. And now they are retreating. Okay. Sorry, what was... Oh, okay. For a second there, I thought we had suffered far more casualties than this. This is not good, but acceptable. Hold it. Is the mayor in a squad? Did I do that? Yep. No. Squad creative fountains. That's not... Okay, mayor was in a squad that no longer exists. That's what that is. Okay. They did not walk into our cage traps. However, this does give us some information to work with. Basically, I want to create a situation here where they can't get to us without walking on the road. Okay. Go ahead and lay out two more caskets. Because that one's going to get used. I think we took two casualties there. Well, we got what we wanted. Oh, you found Geshid, did ya? Good job, I'm proud of you. Claim all that junk. Hopefully they drop some decent gear for us. Sorry, what are you doing? You're serving rye beer excitedly. You walked over to the corpse and said, no, wait, beer. To whom are you serving the beer? Is it Smunstu? Are you serving a beer to Smunstu? No. Where are you going? Oh, now you're being a doctor. Okay. Oh, we suffered many injuries. Okie dokie. Yeah, so we will be relying on traps for our defenses. That's how that's gonna go. Anyway. Hey, but now we know that we can defend ourselves against, I would call that a raid, not a siege. You know, the game called that a siege. I'm not sure that applies. That was just a few guys. A few Thrun's soldiers. Hate those guys. They've just been trouble for us from the beginning. Okay, we do have a couple guys still trying to roll out. Okay, we've got an Axe Lord. Kind of wish you hadn't been trying to leave when that was happening. We all out. Aban the Recruit. You're still picking up equipment. Are you? Oh, I see. You were picking up equipment at the edge of the map. What is this? Huh. Interesting. Somebody dropped loot there, and some of their personal gear, it looks like. Interesting choice. Okay. Oh. We need more. Ah. Must have been an injury. Just keep throwing bodies in. We need doctors? We need doctors. It's fine. Everything's fine. I'm not worried, and neither should you be. Okay, so there was one book there, which we now have in our possession. So, you know, I'm satisfied with that. Okay, so I need to remember not to do raids close to the seasonal autosave, because the sieges, such as they are, tend to come right afterward. That's a birch tree. Birches are beautiful. We have a lot of birches around here. I'm not sure what percentage of them are naturally occurring, probably very close to zero, as the majority are in landscaping, but... Oh, hey, it's our caravan. Okay. Well, I guess give me a second to deal with that then. Okay. So we're still carting things down to the trade depot here, but I wanted to call your attention to this. I haven't seen this before. Smunstu the Goblin Dancer is brawling under the influence. Also listening to a story. This is not a real tantrum, obviously. Unconscious, dizzy, nauseated. So I think it's probably fine. I just haven't seen that before. It makes sense that that would be an option. I just didn't realize it was. Everything's moving a little slowly right now. There's a lot on the map. Ah, yes. Our liaison from the mountain homes. Sure, we can do this part. Why not? What requests do we have? We actually will take steel. We will take steel anvils to melt down to make steel. You are going to bring us clothing. We could use some gypsum plaster. But, like, we're doing pretty well here. So that's all I'm going to ask for. Bring us steel. Okay. And you want splints and shields. That's not going to happen. We can make you some splints, though. We'll just go ahead and make up 50 wooden splints for you for next time. How we doing on carting things? We are getting there. Fath the Craftsdwarf has grown attached to an iron shield. Well, that's what we like to see. Do we have a squad out right now? I have forgotten. We do not. That's probably for the best. We do need ammunition. I don't think we have very much. I mean, you can see that this is what's in the stockpiles. I'm leaving the stairs blocked. Because I want them to have as many opportunities as possible to pick up bolts. Look at all the vomit on their way to defend the fort. You know, assuming that we have the opportunity to get the gates closed in the future. Might not be a bad idea to do something like this. The caravan can still get in, but there are traps now inside the fort. That's a pretty good idea, I think. We'll do it on that side, though. There's no room over there. And we won't be doing any more infill here, probably. We need a metalworking industry. That's going to have to wait for next time. Okay, we got just three more things coming down. Who's bringing it? There we go. There's one. Got it. Here's another one. Yes, good, good. Dishmab the Mason bringing some article of clothing to the depot. Never mind the pile of corpses. That's not worth worrying about, and you shouldn't worry about it. Okay. And then, is that everything? I reckon that's everything. Well, tell you what, let's finish this off with the shopping section. Why not? As long as we're here. Adele currently playing with a minecart. Yes, good. There you go. You don't have time to socialize. Riding the cart through the vomit. Oh, I love it. There's vomit in here. There's vomit everywhere. Okay. Zoom out a little. All righty. What do we need from here? We'll take your. We actually probably don't need the gems, but we're gonna take them. We need clothing, of course. I think we still need clothing. We've actually got plenty of musical instruments still. They have no animals that we need. We can make our own cages. That's not a problem. We will take all the booze. We will be trading back some of this same kind of booze. That's not important. Don't worry about that. Ooh, coffee wood. We'll take the milk, of course, so that we can make cheese. The dwarves love cheese. Separate buckets. Here we go. Steel weapons. Yes, please. We just need. Well, okay, that might be all the good stuff we're gonna get out of this section. There we go, a steel warhammer. Heck yeah. Okay, we're into clothing now. Yep, tunics, socks, shoes, socks. Good shoes and socks, very important. You don't wanna get a trench foot. Or just a blister. Or worse, frostbite. It's a very bad thing. I work outside of this entertainment venue. We've had employees get frostbite before because they were inadequately equipped for conditions that were frankly too cold to be working outside. You know, this is Oregon. It's an entertainment venue. There's really no reason for us to be working outside in sub-freezing temperatures. And yet, that's where we are, and this is why we have a union. Doesn't stop the injustice, but it helps mitigate it. Yeah, we'll take all the textiles. We should be able to afford this. If not, I can bring more stuff over. A lot of leather. We're gonna be going all in on a lot of matched leather. That's kind of interesting. Usually the leather's more of a mixed bag. Giant rat leather, very nice. Owl leather, interesting choice. Ocelot leather, kind of unnecessary. Gibbon leather, please. No. Chimpanzee? Don't skin the chimps. What's wrong with you? Wow, okay, a lot of leather. I must have asked for leather last time and just forgotten about it. There's a real good chance. This is probably my fault. We do not want the bins. I have never found bins to be anything but trouble. Ooh, tiger leather. Now we're talking. That's gonna look great. Okay, this is too much leather, probably. Whatever, I'm gonna make us a whole bunch of clothes. We're just gonna... Everybody's getting a full leather outfit. Perfect. Yep. Awful lot of gibbon leather. See, there's another one. We have what, the black gibbon, the silver gibbon, now we got the white-browed gibbon, we have the Siamang back there. Red panda leather? Stop! Here's a pileated gibbon. A Bilu. Wow, okay. Orangutan leather! Uncalled for! Orangutans are God's most perfect creatures. Why would you do this? And now a white-handed gibbon. Well, at least we're getting a variety. Okay, this is fascinating. And also, this is way too much leather. Cheetah leather. That's pretty cool. Wow, they really are giving us a variety of animals, so I like that. That's pretty cool. Eye-eyes. Why would you bother skinning enough eye-eyes to get the leather? Mandrills, I'm torn on. They are monsters. But is it worth skinning them? Probably not. Armadillos are not real, so that's fine. Giraffe, that's kind of impressive. Spider monkeys, again, why would you bother? Okay, we're done. No, this just keeps going. It just keeps going. Okay, bolts, please. I might have asked for bolts. No, we don't want silver bolts. Silver bolts are garbage. They're heavy enough, but they don't have enough punch. You might have heard my knuckles cracking when I made a fist just there. That's going to be interesting. See if that came through. We'll get all this food. I probably should have cut this part out, but we're here now. Okay, you know what? We are actually all set on interesting foodstuffs, so we are going to call it on that. That's fine. In fact, I'm bored now. So we're going to give them all this. We make them take the white stuff in trade. This is our strategy now. Oh, that's a lot of it. But I don't want it, so they have to take it all. They have to take it all. Mm-hmm. Okay, is that it? Is that all of it? Nope. Dog hair earring. They have to take that. I do not want that. Okay, I believe that is all of the white stuff, so they can have that. And these are the gifts that they must take. There we go. Please leave. I am done with you. And I'm also done with this episode. So, hey folks, thanks for watching. Thanks to those of you who are subscribed to the channel. Thanks to those of you who are not yet subscribed to the channel. And thanks, as always, to those of you watching this without ever intending to subscribe to the channel, because you count too. Every view counts. We will be back here next week with some more Dwarf Fortress horror content on Saturdays. We're currently doing a run on Dredge. That's going up most Wednesdays. Lots of content on the channel for you to check out. Please feel free to make suggestions, things you'd like to see on the channel, things you'd like me to see on your channel, things you'd like to see here in the fort. They don't even have to be good ideas. I'll take bad ideas. All right, I'm going to go get ready for work. I will see you folks next time. And until then, Birdman out.